There are quite a number of similarities between the war in Ukraine today and the wars in the former Yugoslavia. One of the similarities is that you had a big country, the Soviet Union and Yugoslavia, which broke up into smaller pieces with the military might left in the biggest of the remaining countries. In Yugoslavia's case, it was Serbia. And in the case of the Soviet Union, it was Russia. In both Yugoslavia and the former Soviet Union, there were large groups, ethnic groups, left in other countries. For Russia, it was the Russians in the Donbass parts of Ukraine, which was used as the pretext for the military operation now. In Yugoslavia, it was the Serbs in Bosnia and in Croatia. The difference is that in Yugoslavia, all the political leaders of all the national groups were prepared for a conflict and in some cases welcomed it with open hands. The politicians in today's Russia and Ukraine seem to have learned some messages from the Yugoslav wars because their propaganda on both sides is a lot more sophisticated than it was during the Yugoslav wars. The Ukrainians are mimicking what the Croatians did, claiming losses among the Russians and showing what they say are their victories, while the Russians are not being as heavy-handed as the Serbian propaganda machine was in the 1990s. And of course, we have to talk about NATO and what it did in this. And NATO is the same heavy-handed, bumbling organization that it was in the 1990s and is not helping at all in resolving this quickly.
Lajmi më i shpejt në celularin tënd.